Carl.
Clean them out.
Oh, boy.
Bring it!
Well, Roy, you seem to like my country.
Like it? I think it's marvelous. See, I wish we were staying here 2 years instead of just 2 weeks. But you know, Carl, it does sound funny hearing you call it your country. I keep forgetting you're not English.
Sometimes I feel almost English.
Well,
myself.
That's natural. After all, you can't be at Oxford 3 years without feeling slightly British. I wish Helen were here.
After all you've said about her, I don't blame you.
Come here, John. Wait a minute. Good God. Your brother is not coming today, Herr Rudnitz?
Oh, yes. He'll be along soon, Gretchen. Nothing can keep Monty away from this good beer.
Nothing except a good-looking woman.
You're born. That brother of yours, he's a naughty boy. But I like him.
He has a way with him, eh, Gretchen?
You don't know half of it.
Another conquest for Monty.
Yes. I don't know why he wants to mess about with every woman he meets.
Yeah, but you have Helen.
Not at all sure. I'm not half good enough for her.
She must be a wonderful girl.
Oh, she is. She's marvelous. We'll have to meet her when we get back to Oxford.
I'd like to.
Would you like to see what she looks like?
Yes. I didn't know you had a photograph of her.
Yeah, neither does Helen. I took it myself when she wasn't looking.
Really? Oh.
Stunning, isn't she?
Why, she's marvelous.
Cheer all you blighters.
Hello, Smarty.
Beat the counters. Step up, gents, the one and only.
Now, Marty, don't please.
Oh, it's all right. This little pretzel doesn't understand a word of English.
No?
Gretchen!
Yeah!
Vi, Snell!
Found it in the museum.
Yeah, she's a work of art, all right.
You should have left her there.
Don't you need to?
I say, Molly, why do you bring around this sword?
Bring her? Good heavens, I can't get rid of her. Go home, will you? Go home!
Oh, what doggin'
You see, I'm stuck.
Hello, who's the dowager?
That's Helen.
Oh.
But of course, that's only a snapshot. Wait till you meet her.
Oh, yeah?
Go away!
What's that, Gensy?
I say, this is getting serious.
I've got to get rid of her. Oh, you know, I've a very important engagement in just 15 minutes. I say, you chaps, be sporting and take her off my hands.
But after all, Marty,
listen, we may be sporting, but we're not feeble-minded.
Well, you can do what you please with her. I'm going.
Hey, listen, hey, Marty.
Auf Wiedersehen, meine ungebetene Mahlzeit.
Yeah, just a minute now, please.
Leave it to me.
Yeah.
I'll get rid of her.
Please, yes.
Nun.
Yes.
Nun, mein Fräulein.
Ach, Sie sind schon deutsch.
Ja.
Nine.
Carry on. Pretty boy, you please me very much.
It is nothing. I am not at home to anyone except my husband. And he is away on army business. He will not be home for hours. So you see...
Army.
Erich, bitte.
Ruhig.
But really, I say you mustn't think that...
Your name?
My name is Rutledge, sir.
You are stopping in Munich?
At the Hotel Bayerischer Hof, sir.
My seconds will call on you later.
What I say, you...
There is nothing further to discuss.
Sailing, sailing over the bounding main, for many a wintry wind shall blow ere Jack comes home again.
Hello.
Sailing, sailing.
Where are you going?
England.
England? Why, we're not going back for 10 days. What's wrong? Baron von Krenz. Who's he?
Oh, he's just a friend of mine.
Really? Quite a social success, aren't you? How do you meet these barons?
Well, unfortunately, I met this one through his wife.
And this means...
A duel. Can you imagine it?
Running away?
Oh, don't be an ass, Roy. You don't expect me to go through with a farce like this.
But, Monty, it's the only thing you can do.
Oh, there you go again. I suppose when a woman's no good and her husband finds it out, I've got to get shot just because it's the honorable thing to do.
Well, what do you think people will say? You'll never live it down.
What do I care what people say?
Well, you can talk all you like, Monty, but you can't walk out like this.
Can't I? Goodbye. See you at Oxford.
Hello, Roy.
Hello, Carl.
Oh, what's up? Where's Monty?
He's gone to England.
England? Well, what's the matter?
Oh, nothing.
But I say...
Heritage? Heritage?
Yes.
Von Richter.
Von Sleven.
We represent Colonel Baron von Krenz.
Yes.
Have you chosen your second? According to custom, we have selected the time and place. You have the choice of weapons. What is your choice?
What is then loose with them cattle?
What is this?
Golden Hour. Why, that's a famous dueling place near here. It says at 4 o'clock tomorrow morning.
4 o'clock in the morning.
Well, how did this happen?
I'm sorry, Carl. I lost my temper with one of your officers.
But, Roy...
Hey, Carl, do you know how to be a second?
Yuraval.
Bitte wählen Sie.
Bitte? Habt ihr Ehre?
Habt ihr Ehre?
Habt ihr Ehre? Kommen Sie. Dies sind 20 Schritt. Ihre Partei steht auf dieser Linie. Auf drei wird geschossen. Der Gegner steht dort. Danke.
Good luck, Roy.
Fertig. Eins. Zwei. Drei. Verwundung dort.
It's just a little scratch. I was hunting in Germany. Oh. I'll see you at dinner.
Righto.
Good.
See you later.
Say, why aren't you getting dressed? Aren't you coming with me to meet Helen?
Oh, yes, but don't remind me of it.
Don't be foolish. She expects us for tea.
Tea?
Listen, it'll do you good to meet a nice girl.
Oh, well, all right, but first we've got to get you dressed. Say, we've got to get him dressed. He's going to see
a
girl.
Now, wait a minute now. You, listen, I've got to have my shirt. Listen,
quick, hurry up.
Hey, wait a minute. Listen, I'm old enough to dress myself.
No, you're not.
Will you cut it out? Say, listen, will you please? Hey, my green socks. Helen in?
Miss Helen is not at home, sir.
She's expecting us.
Would you care to wait?
Yes, thank you.
Fine reception. Oh.
Roy, maybe she's forgotten.
Not Helen, she's not that sort.
Sick. I think I'd better go.
Monty, will you sit down?
Oh, I've got an awful headache. I think I'll go to the chemist and get something for it.
Monty.
Roy.
Helen.
Oh, terribly sorry. Mother's fall shopping. I simply flew. My, isn't it hot?
You shouldn't have hurried so.
Oh, but I wanted to. Roy, you've no right to look so cool. I'm broiling. Feel.
Yes, you are, aren't you?
No, not one.
Well, you're so marvelous, I hardly dare.
Oh, silly. Well, that's better. Cigarette, Roy? I thought your brother was coming.
Went out with a headache.
Poor boy, it must be the heat.
Thank you.
Well, they've done it.
I never thought they would. I still can't believe it.
Well, it must be true. It's official.
Oh, shut up. I'm trying to think.
It's terrible.
Carl, you won't have to go, will you?
Me? Oh, Roy, I hope not. Oh, they can't want me. I'm not a soldier. What use would I be to them? I couldn't kill anyone. They couldn't make me do that, could they, Roy?
Well, I think it'll all be over in a couple of weeks.
I'm not so sure.
I wouldn't worry about it.
Then suppose England comes in. Why, Roy, that'd be horrible. I never could do that. Why, I love England.
Oh, will you shut up?
Monty, Germany's declared war on France.
Hmm? Oh, Roy, how do you spell ecstatic? Hmm?
Special delivery letter for Carl Arnstedt.
What's the matter, Carl? Someone ill? Carl.
May I ask the Prime Minister if he has any information he can give us today?
Our ambassador at Berlin received his passport at 7 o'clock last evening. And since 11 o'clock last night, a state of war has existed between Germany and ourselves.
7? What time?
7:30.
How do you want?
38.
38.
I'm afraid it's a bit small, sir.
Move along there, move along. You'll grow into it.
Slow.
Hans?
Come on there, come on. Present.
Hans?
Give it to him, you bloody fool. Hey, what's wrong with you? Sleeping sickness? Here, here. Let go of that gun, you clinging vine. Let go, do you? God, you're enough to turn a man's stomach. Hey, you with the fallen arches.
I've enlisted, Monty, in the Royal Flying Corps.
You're a fool, Roy.
Oh, really? How lovely. My grandfather was in the guards during the revolution.
Oh, he was?
Oh, Roy, you look marvelous in uniform.
Thank you.
Doesn't he?
It's ripping.
Where?
Tell me, what have you joined?
No, the Royal Flying Corps.
Oh, of course.
Isn't it a new
shade? And all the misery in this world has been caused by and for capitalism. Why should we fight this war? For capitalism? You will die. You will die. All your sons will die. For capitalism. Down with capitalism. Down with war.
Down with the anarchists.
That's right. Timmy. Can't you be back now? Who do you think is Shelby?
There's the man I'd like to kiss.
Afraid of a kiss?
Maybe he's yeller.
Go on, you. Go in and fought for your country.
Let
her.
Hey,
I'd rather marry the girl.
Tonight's the night, Monty.
Yeah.
Say, listen, be more cheerful. You have a treat in store meeting, Helen.
Must be Friday the 13th.
I wonder if she'll wear her canteen uniform.
She does, you can count me out.
Oh, she looks stunning in it.
Who wants to be stunned? I'm only going as a favor to you. You and I don't like the same kind of girl.
Hurry up, will you?
Oh, it's a waste of time to polish these. She'll probably step all over them the first dance anyway. Safer to sit in a quiet little corner and have a chat about votes for women.
Hello there.
Hello.
Whose window are you warbling under tonight?
Lady Randolph's charity ball. Wash your neck and come along.
Oh, but I haven't been invited.
That's all right. I'm on the committee.
No, I don't think I'll go.
A smart boy.
She should be here by this time.
How do you do, sir?
There she is.
Don't point, it's rude.
Oh, Helen!
Roy!
Hello,
Irving. You're frightfully late. I was afraid you weren't coming.
Oh, Helen, this is Monty.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Well, that's done at last. You know, you two have been avoiding each other for weeks. Helen, may I have this next dance?
Of course. There you are.
Good evening, Lady Randolph.
I must say you take your duties on my committee very nicely. Where have you been? You completely disarranged my program. There are no end of things to be done. Helen, dear, you don't mind, do you? Come along, Roy. Come on.
I'm sorry, Helen. Monty, would you take this next dance with Helen?
Oh, how do you do, Monty? How do you do? Now, come along. Well...
I really must go and find Jimmy Kerrigan. He has something most important to tell me.
is this Jimmy Carrigan?
Carrigan? I've never heard of him. What are you thinking of?
If you must know, I was thinking of Marty.
Do you like him?
Yes, I like him. He's a marvelous dancer.
Well, Marty does all those things well. Helen.
What?
May I?
Marty.
Oh, hello there.
Come sit down.
You're having a better time than you expected, Marty?
Marvelous. Been dancing with a beautiful brunette, name of Eleanor. She's perfect.
Oh, Eleanor Madden. You don't really think she's beautiful.
Kitty, 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 kitty.
Stop it. I'm not a cat.
Yes, you are.
Well, if I'm a kitty, I'm a thirsty kitty. Roy, dear, would you please get me a glass of punch?
Why, of course I will.
No, I'll go, Roy.
No, I'm the committee. You stay here, look after this wallflower.
But really, I...
Oh, if you'd rather not.
Well, I didn't mean...
Don't you like wallflowers?
I shouldn't have done that.
Oh, you're not sorry, Marty.
Awfully sorry. I had no right to.
What if I'm glad?
But what about Roy?
Isn't that my business?
I suppose so, but...
Hush.
Really...
Compliments to the committee.
Thanks awfully, Roy.
Well, has he been properly charming? Me?
More than charming.
Good for you, Marty. Loves me.
She blisters you.
It's worth it.
Is she worth it?
Depends on who she is. Hello.
Hello.
Well, thank goodness Lady Randolph lost sight of me for a minute.
Roy, you've been neglecting me shamefully.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. You see, it's this beastly committee. Lady Randolph won't let me alone a minute.
Oh, Roy, there you are.
Yes, here I am.
Never mind. Where is that list? Would you mind finding Sir John for me? It's about my canteen unit. I must have the Queen's signature. So important. My dear, why don't you get into your uniform? You look so pretty in it. And Monty, shouldn't you dance with Mary Blunt?
Yes, why
and
don't
Roy,
you?
Roy, well, you found Sir John? I want you to lead the barn dance for me. And really, there are so many things you've got to do. You
yes,
should see me for one
I'm
moment.
I'm terribly sorry. Back soon.
You see those girls that
I know, but Lady Randolph, I spoke to her.
Oh, you've really joined Lady Liz's canteen unit.
Rather. Chance of a lifetime. We go to France in 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
Well, Roy says you're sailing the 15th.
That's so. Bored?
Tired. Take me home, Marty.
Home?
It's not far. I've taken a flat in town near canteen headquarters.
I I mean, Roy will be quite upset to find you're gone.
That's what he gets for being on committee.
But really?
Very well, I'll find someone else.
Oh, I didn't mean to be rude.
Well, come on then. Are we here?
Well, it's number 27.
Want to come up for a cigarette and a drink?
Oh, really? You must be awfully tired.
No, I'm not. Come see my rooms. I've only had a place of my own for a week. It's a new toy.
What a baby you are.
Hurry up.
All right. Well, this is jolly.
Sit down and I'll get you a drink.
Thanks.
Say when.
Oh, when?
Would you be shocked if I put on something more comfortable?
I'll try to survive. Well, are you more comfortable now?
Yes. Are you?
Oh, yes. You know, it seems strange being here like this after hearing Roy rave about you for months.
Does Roy rave?
Or rather, he idolizes you.
Oh, I do wish he wouldn't. It makes me feel guilty.
I can understand his raving now.
Oh, don't be silly. You're not a bit like Roy, are you?
I should say not. Roy is frightfully high-minded. He doesn't approve of me.
He wouldn't approve of me either if he knew what I'm really like.
Doesn't he know?
No. When I'm with Roy, I'm the way Roy wants me to be. That's caddish, isn't it? But I can't help it.
I understand.
Roy wouldn't.
May I ask you a very personal question?
Yes.
Do you love Roy?
No, not really. Not the way Roy wants me to love him. I can't. Roy's love means marriage and children and never anyone but Roy. I couldn't bear that. I want to be free. I want to be gay and have fun. Life's short, and I want to live while I'm alive.
I know that. That's the way I feel, too. I think I'd better go.
Must you?
I really should.
Pull.
cold in here now, isn't it? Have you a match? Why so gloomy?
God, I'm rotten.
I can't see it.
Can't you? Well, then you're rotten, too.
What do you mean?
Then Roy worships you. You.
Well?
Don't you make yourself sick. You and Roy. God, that's funny.
Get out of here.
Don't worry, I can't get out fast enough.
Get out! And stay out!
Where have you been?
Oh, I stopped at a bar after I took Helen home.
Oh. How'd you like her?
Oh, she's all right.
Passing the gravity.
I dare say she would.
Just what do you mean by that?
Listen, Roy, let me tell you something, even if it hurts.
Yes?
I wouldn't be so idealistic about Helen if I were you.
And why not?
Well, I just wouldn't, that's all.
Well, why not?
Oh, I don't know. Forget it.
Never mind crawling. Out with it.
Listen, Roy, I tell you, women are all the same.
You look at every woman as a barmaid. You don't know anything about decent women.
Oh, all right. You know it all, then.
No, you've said enough. Shut up.
Ausgezeichnet, in 15 Minuten sind wir bereits da.
Schon?
Ja.
Er soll die Karte ansehen.
Ja, von ihm hängt alles ab.
Karl. Karl. Karl!
Zu Befehl.
Du gibst die Karte.
Zu Befehl.
Und genau. Informieren Sie ihn gut.
Selbstverständlich. Karl, wir kommen hier die Themse hinauf nach London hinein. Unser Ziel ist Trafalgar Square, das Herz von London. Alle Bomben müssen möglichst in nächster Umgebung sitzen. Da liegt die Exchange für die City Hall. Passen Sie auf. Haben Sie gehört, was ich gesagt habe?
Ja.
Step up ahead. South by east.
Right, Charles.
I'll have to go. I'm tired.
Oh, shut up.
Come on. Let's go. Hurry up. Come on.
Be right with you, Elliot.
Come on, Monty. Get up.
All right.
All right. Let's go. Hurry.
Captain, wir sind da.
Halt, halt!
Karl, Ziel genau und ruhig Blut. Unser Erfolg hängt vollkommen von deiner Genauigkeit ab. Wie wird's?
Karl.
Los, weiter, weiter. Genug, genug.
Karl, diesmal müssen wir schaffen. Ganz London müssen wir in die Luft blasen. Diese Nacht dürfen die Engländer nie vergessen. Mach's gut, Karl. Fertig. Los. Viel Glück.
Danke.
Genug. Geradeaus, weiter.
Halbe Kraft voraus.
Halbe Kraft voraus. Licht, halbe Kraft voraus. Thank you.
Jetzt rechts! Zwei Bomben!
Zwei Bomben!
Zwei Bomben! Perfekt! Schuss direkt auf das Alge Square. Bei Karl, sehr fein. Sechs Bomben!
Sechs Bomben! Sechs Bomben!
Schuss genau auf. Ausgezeichnet! Alle Bomben!
Jawohl, Kapitän! Alle Bomben!
Objekt der Beschießung. Total vernichtet.
Ah, famos, Karl! Halbe Kraft voraus!
Halbe Kraft voraus!
Meter unter uns, 2000 Meter achter aus, an Steuerbord.
Der Teufel! Volle Kraft voraus!
Volle Kraft voraus! Volle Kraft voraus!
Wasserballast über Bord!
Herr Henke, holen Sie, wenn Sie nicht schnell machen!
Wir müssen Höhe gewinnen! Der Funke soll Ihnen helfen!
Jawohl, Herr Kapitän! Wasserballast! Schnell!
Maschinengewehre!
Jawohl!
Fahren Sie langsam. Was ist denn los damit? Wir sollten schneller fahren. Wir müssen 60 Knoten machen.
Die Motoren vielleicht?
Maschine, läuft die Motor volle Kraft? Wie viele Umdrehungen machen Sie?
1200.
Wie viel?
1200.
1200.
Bitte, was denken Sie davon? Unsere Motoren laufen alle äußerste Kraft. Wir steigen nur 10 Grad und machen nicht mehr als 50 Knoten. Was ist denn los damit?
Ja, der Luftwiderstand von dem Beobachterkorb und den 2000 Meter Kabel vermindern unsere Fahrt um mindestens 15 Knoten.
So? Ganz sicher?
Absolut.
Wie viele Meter müssen Sie noch aufwinden? Haben Sie noch viel nach? Dauert es noch lange? Wie lange dauert es noch?
10 Minuten.
Halt! An die Drahtschiene! Halt! Die Maschine!
Ich kann es nicht.
Kapitän! Kapitän!
Für Kaiser und Vaterland!
Thank you.
sein, dass die Flieger uns nicht verfolgen können. 5000 Meter Höhe müssen wir unter allen Umständen gewinnen. Alles über Bord, was wir nicht unbedingt brauchen. Das Schiff muss leichter werden. So schnell wie möglich, verstanden?
Jawohl.
Franz! Schmeißen Sie den ganzen Apparat über Bord.
Radio?
Schnell!
Jawohl.
Richter, alles überflüssig über Bord. Schnell!
Über Bord geworfen, was wir irgendwie entbehren können. Aber die Flieger, die verdammten Kerle, kommen uns noch immer näher.
Oh, was jetzt?
Herr Kapitän, Sie wissen, es bleibt uns nichts anderes übrig. Sie wissen, es gibt nur noch ein einziges Mittel, das Schiff leichter zu machen. Habe ich Ihre Erlaubnis?
Ja. Es fällt mir schwer, Klein. Aber das Schiff muss gerettet werden. Wir haben keine andere Wahl.
Bauer, kommen Sie.
Befehl.
Sind Sie willens, wie Ihr Vaterland zu sterben?
Jawohl. Ihr größter Dienst.
just our luck.
Lucky we weren't both killed.
Well, we're through.
Herr Kapitän, sind keine Feindflieger mehr zu sehen. Anscheinend haben wir die alle abgeschossen.
Ah, das war feine Arbeit, mein Lieber. Ah, ja.
Look out! Run!
Just a minute. Why the blazes don't you look where you're going, sir?
I'm sorry, sir.
Isn't it customary to salute one's superior officer? Thank you. What is your name, sir?
Lieutenant Roy Rutledge.
Make a note of that.
Yes, sir.
They are. They glisten in the sun.
What the hell are you trying to do? It took me 3 hours right there. You're nothing but a pest anyhow.
Oh,
sit
down. Down.
Have a little fun.
You shouldn't smoke so many.
What difference does it make?
You know it's bad for you.
Buy a chocolate, miss. Change, miss.
Please. That's a good boy.
What a life it would be married to you.
Oh, you don't fancy it?
Beastly, no smokes.
Think of all the money we'd save.
What would we spend it on?
Oh, a diamond dog collar.
For me?
No, I'd buy a muzzle for you.
You wouldn't spoil my beautiful mustache, would you?
No. We'd keep that in the parlor under glass.
Hello, Helen.
Oh, hello, Roy. Roy, I'd like you to meet Captain Redfield, Lieutenant Rutledge.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Beastly weather.
Yes, isn't it?
You'll get used to it.
Thanks. Gee, it's great to see you again, Helen. It's been 4 whole days.
Really?
Have you been over long?
3 weeks.
Oh. 3 weeks.
Everything all right up your way?
Oh, yes.
Your squadron near here?
20 miles up the line.
20 miles? That far? You chaps have it rather soft, haven't you?
Do you think so?
Oh, well, I mean to say, being able to dash about the countryside and all that. Wish I'd picked the RFC.
Well, why didn't you?
Roy.
Well, I must be going.
Oh, don't go.
I think I'd better. Goodbye, Helen. And don't forget your promise.
I won't.
Who's that bag of wind?
Would you mind not talking about my friends like that?
Oh, now, Helen, please.
Oh, you were perfectly beastly to him.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Guess my nerves are a bit raw. Things haven't been so easy this last week.
Oh, you've been fighting? Did you shoot down any Boche?
Yes, I managed to get a couple.
Really? How thrilling. Tell me about it.
Well, there's really nothing much to tell.
3 bars of chocolate, miss.
Soup, it's soap.
Hey, I think it's shoe polish.
Right. Sorry, sir.
cook said the soup was a bit weak tonight. Maybe you taste the disinfectant in the water, sir.
Oh, that'll work.
Well, strike me blind, it's a hair.
Wash it off and wear it, Baldy.
Hello, you chaps.
Hello, Baldy.
How goes it? Still no news of Harry? No. Somebody always gets it on the night patrol. What do you think, Marriott? You saw it happen. Is there any chance he got down alive?
No, I don't think so. The searchlights got him. We were flying low and they heard us. We started to climb, but it was too late. Shrapnel began bursting all around him. Two bursts caught him and he started to drop. It was awful to see him down there. Twisting and diving, crippled, always dropping. Trying every way to get clear of those lights. Then another burst got him.
We could hear him screaming.
Off, I can't stand it. Good thing he took your place, Rutledge. You might have got it instead of him.
Oh, I'll get it sooner or later. We'll all get it. Isn't there any end to this?
Oh, shut up. You're always whining.
Shut up yourself.
Who'll make
it? I'll let you.
Sit down, Jerry.
Be quiet.
All right. What's the matter, you fellas?
Would anybody like to take Monty's place on tonight's patrol?
Oh, yeah.
No more soup. No more soup.
Beneath the zoo.
Next course, baby. Next course.
That's what comes from money.
What was dinner before you dropped it, Jimes?
A tasty bit of salmon, sir.
Sewer trout again? Hasn't the cook anything else?
Well, sir, there's that tin of pork and beans.
No, we don't. Can he do anything with the garbage?
Oh, well, never mind. We all know.
Coffee, Jimes?
Yes, sir.
And Jimes?
Yes, sir.
Don't let anything hurry you.
No, sir.
You dirty liar!
The sooner you get shot down, the better.
Oh,
Baldy, Charlie.
Now that didn't hurt, Baldy.
Baldy, Baldy.
Stop, hey, Baldy!
Following officers will report for night patrol. Drayton.
Yes, sir.
Fuller.
Here, sir.
Maloney.
Oh, no, not an old bald-headed man like me up there in the cold, cold air.
Perhaps Fritz will warm it up for you. Nibble.
Yes, sir.
Monty Rutledge. Monty Rutledge.
I don't feel very well tonight, sir.
That's all right, boy. None of us feel well.
But you don't understand.
I think I do, Rutledge.
But I say, sir, you don't understand. There seems to be something the matter with me.
I know what's the matter with him. He's yellow.
Oh, shut up.
Oh, let's say it. Didn't Harry go west last night because he took this man's place?
Keep quiet, sir.
I'll not keep quiet. He's yellow and we all know it.
That's a lie. I'm not yellow. I can see things as they are, that's all. And I'm sick of this rotten business. You fools, why do you let him kill you like this? What are you fighting for? Patriotism, duty. Are you mad? Can't you see they're just words? Words coined by politicians and profiteers to trick you into fighting for them. What's a word compared with life, the only life you've got? I'll give them a word. Murder, that's what this dirty, rotten politician's war is. Murder, you know it as well as I do. Yellow, am I? You're the ones that are yellow. I've got guts to say what I think. You're afraid to say it. So afraid of being called yellow, you'd rather be killed first. You fools, you poor, stupid fools.
Oh, Marty, now pull yourself together, will you?
Turn up, Rutledge. I've taken a lot of shirking from you since we came out here, but this is a bit too much.
Sure, he really is ill.
You're a disgrace to your squadron. Go to your quarters.
Yes, sir.
I hope.
Have a cigarette.
You don't think I'm yellow, do you, Roy?
Why, of course not. You're just more sensitive than the rest of us.
I wonder.
Well, stop thinking about it.
I wish I could. Haven't I been up twice on the night patrol? I'm trying to do my share.
Of course you are now.
You must be pretty well fed up with me after all this.
Oh, that's rot.
I'm not yellow. I'm not!
Oh, now, Monty, come on. Pull yourself together.
Staff Colonel, everybody out.
Come on, Monty.
Stand easy. Well, men, I don't like what I have to say, but let's face it. You all know the central munition dump at Sprague. You've tried three times to bomb that depot without success. No fault of yours, of course. They've guarded it too closely. That munition depot at Sprague must be destroyed tomorrow morning. Now then, today a German bombing plane was forced down within our lines. We were lucky enough to capture it before they had a chance to destroy it. We fixed it up so it will fly. And we want to use this plane to bomb the Sprague depot. There's no question that the venture will succeed this time. The enemy won't suspect one of their own planes until after the depot is bombed. Then, when they discover the trick, well, you may have a little difficulty in getting back. I need two men to fly this plane.
I'll go, sir.
Are you sure you want to go?
Quite sure, sir.
Very well.
I'll go with him, sir.
Who are these men?
Lieutenants Monty and Roy Rutledge, sir.
Brothers, eh?
Dismiss.
Now, young men, I want you to realize how important this is. The 7th Brigade has been ordered to go over the top in a surprise attack tomorrow evening at dusk. The brigade doesn't know it, but I'm afraid they're going to be slaughtered. There's too much artillery in front of us. If you destroy that munition depot early tomorrow morning, it will weaken the enemy artillery and we may be able to get through. Hundreds of lives depend on you. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now another thing. The plane you are to fly is far too dangerous a piece of armament to let the enemy recapture it. It must return or be destroyed. If you were captured, you'd be shot as spies anyway.
Boley. Oh, Boley. You'll take the morning patrol in towards Sprague as far as you can. You might possibly help them get back.
By all means.
Yes, sir.
You'll get your maps and final instructions just before taking off. Report to the field at 3 a.m. Until then, let them do as they please.
Yes, sir. 3 o'clock, you two.
Yes, sir.
Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
What time is it, Monty?
9:10.
Helen's canteen closes at 10. We've just enough time to get there.
You think they'll let us have the motorcycle?
Why, of course. We're it tonight.
Yeah, we're it all right.
Not sorry, are you?
Oh, let's not talk about it. I'm not even going to think about it until 3 o'clock.
What's your program? Wine, women, and song?
Oh, perhaps I'll do without the song tonight.
See it, Brosons?
Either there or Jack's across the street, wherever you hear the most noise.
Don't you want to come in with me to see Helen?
Oh, I better not. Better not.
Righto.
Where's Helen?
She's gone out.
Oh.
Was she expecting you?
No.
Would you care to leave a note?
Yes, I think I will.
Pen and ink on the table.
You'll see if she gets this.
Oh, yes.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Hello, what's up?
She isn't in.
That's tough. Want to come along with me?
Where to?
Grossen's.
Righto. You switch on.
Let's get out of here.
Oh, let's have it out. I don't love you. I never have. I never had any fun with you anyway, you and your high ideals. You're too good to live. You're just a stupid prig, if you ask me. You make me sick. Do you hear? Sick. Now get out of here. I hate the sight of you.
Come on, Roy. Let's go across the street.
Forget it.
If you find sick.
No, you'll be all right. Drink up, Roy.
I still can't believe it.
You just don't know anything about women. They're all the same. I've been telling you that for years. Maybe you'll believe me now.
Oh, Helen's not that sort.
Oh, nonsense.
The war, she's changed.
Oh, you're wrong, Roy.
War doesn't change people. It's like getting drunk. It brings out what people really are.
You can't make me believe Helen was like that before.
Well, she was. I've known it all along.
You too?
Oh, I'm sorry, Roy. Don't take it so hard. She isn't worth it.
I suppose you're right.
Of course I'm right. Listen, Roy. Never love a woman. Just make love to her. You see? Like this, look.
We come south again.
Go ahead, Roy. Try it. That's the way.
Listen, Monty. Monty, go easy. We gotta go up at 3 o'clock.
Oh, listen, Roy. The hell with this 3 o'clock business.
What do you mean?
Just that. The hell with it.
Say, you're crazy, Monty. We can't get out of it now.
Oh, why can't we? Say, listen, Roy. All this idealistic stuff won't get you anywhere. You tried it on Helen, and what happened? You got a kick in the face. You can't go through life thinking the way you do. People take advantage of you and make a fool of you the way she did.
You're beginning to look as though you're right.
Of course I'm right. I was right about Helen, and now I'm right about this 3 o'clock business, too.
This is another thing entirely, Monty.
Why is it? They're just taking advantage of you in another way, that's all. There's chaps like you that are meat for them. All they gotta do is make it sound heroic, and you fall for it.
Listen, Roy. What's the difference if we don't go? But we can't get out of it now.
Oh, why can't we? Listen, tell him the motorcycle broke down. Tell him anything. What do you say, Roy?
Well.
Come on.
Want that pêche et bozou?
Oh, baby! N'est-ce pas?
Oh, mais oui, oui, madame.
Oh, baby!
Oh, stop looking at your watch, Roy. You're not going anywhere.
Yes, I am, and so are you.
Please,
as I am. We're a little drunk, and we've been talking wildly. There's no way out of this, and we know it. Come on, Monty.
No, no. Let me alone. Come on, Ooh-la-la.
Oh, oui, mon petit chéri.
Monty! Why, they'd court-martial us in a minute if we didn't show up. Why, that's desertion, Monty. They shoot people for that. Come on. Let's get out of here. Come on. Come on.
I suppose you're right. What a pair of
foot.
Let's go.
Easy.
Look out for the firing pin.
Righto. I got it.
Watch out, sir. All right.
Just for all the shooting ground speed here. Keep this sight train on the target. Then throw the release when you hit the stop. You understand? Don't forget the level there. Goodbye.
Bye. Contact, please. Contact.
that this ship weighs 20,000 pounds. Left.
Help me. werden wir angegriffen.
Eine kolossale Katastrophe!
Wir müssen aber riesige Gründe dazu gehabt haben.
Die Sprengung des Munitionsdepots hat eine große Attacke zu bedeuten.
Ganz gewiss, Exzellenz.
Hauptquartier, die zwei Engländer gefangen genommen. Danke, Schluss.
Exzellenz, wir müssen die Angriffspläne der Engländer herausfinden.
Nun,
Exzellenz, die zwei Engländer zur Stelle.
Schön, reinbringen.
Zu Befehl, Exzellenz.
Tür zu.
Zu Befehl, Exzellenz. Eintreten.
We meet again. It was you who bombed the depot at Sprauk, nicht wahr?
Yes.
And you were flying a German plane, nicht wahr?
Yes.
Very clever. It is a pity you must take your congratulations from me. There are a few questions I must ask you. If you answer them simply, it will be easy for you. To what squadron of the Royal Flying Corps are you attached? Just why were you sent to bomb that munition depot this morning?
It was our natural target.
But possibly it was to clear the way for a little surprise attack, eh? Ah, you are surprised. We know all about it. So you need not be afraid to talk. Now, please, when and where is the attack to be made? Oh, you are stupid not to tell. It is nothing. For you, the war is over, nicht wahr? We are friends. Listen. If you tell me, I will see that you are sent to a special camp reserved only for certain prisoners of war. It is near Munich, far away from all this. You will have every comfort. And then a few months from now, when the war is over, you will be alive and in good health, which is more than most of us will be able to say. So you see, it can be easy for you. Now, please. So, you will not tell. Possibly you do not know that flying a German plane is the same as wearing a German uniform. Any disguised soldier is a spy, nicht wahr? And you know what happens to spies. I think you two friends had better talk it over. I will give you 15 minutes. If you change your mind and tell, good. If not, you will be shot. So tell it, Zurück.
Abtreten.
Zu Befehl, Exzellenz. Abtreten.
Do you think he was bluffing?
No, he wasn't bluffing.
He's the man I was to fight that duel with.
Really? Quite a coincidence.
He's got it in for me.
Ah, oh, he's probably forgotten it by this time. The brigade will be going over pretty soon, Monty.
Yes.
Legs up! That's clear up! Now don't hesitate, that's clear!
Marty, look.
I'll save it to wipe your nose on.
God, what nerve. Roy. Roy, I can't face it. I'm going to tell.
Don't be a fool, Marty. Do you realize what it would mean if we told?
It would mean being alive when this bloody war's over.
But, Marty, you can't.
Well, to hell with your heroic stuff. I want to live. I'm not going to be shot down like that. I'm going to tell.
So wait a minute, Marty.
But I...
Yes. Let me go.
You?
Yes. You're all upset.
I'll bargain with him, and perhaps I won't have to tell him everything. I'll come with you.
No. You said he's got it in for you. Now let me do it alone.
All right.
Tell the general I'm ready to talk.
Good, come.
Glow with the attack in here, Excellenz.
Wirklich, aber dieses Terrain hier.
Die Hauptsache ist die Zeit der Attacke, Excellenz. Die Zeit der Attacke müssen wir haben.
Nun?
Excellenz, einer der Engländer wünscht, Excellenz zu sprechen.
Jetzt kommt raus. Reinbringen.
Zu Befehl, Excellenz.
Danke, meine Herren.
Zu Befehl, Excellenz. Eintreten.
So you have changed your mind?
Yes. My friend will never tell. But I want to live. I'm ready to talk.
You are very wise. Now, please, draw a rough map for me showing your positions, brigade numbers, this position, hour of attack, purpose, number of men.
Wait a minute. I'll tell only on one condition.
A condition?
Yes. If I give this information, my friend will know it. Back home after the war, he'll tell everyone that I was a traitor.
You leave that to me.
Why not let me have that satisfaction?
What do you mean? I do not understand. One does not kill a friend.
Friend? He's not my friend. He stole the girl I love, and I hate him.
Huh. History repeats itself. You make rather hard terms.
I'll tell only on that condition.
One bullet.
What if I miss? Give me two to make sure.
No. A good soldier will need only one.
Very well.
Not so fast. Lieutenant, geben Sie dem Kerl dieses Magazin draußen.
To the Felix Lenz.
He will give you the bullet outside.
I didn't tell Monty.
Why, what happened? Has he changed his mind?
No. Don't you think you can go through with it now?
What do you mean?
Oh, of course we can. It won't even hurt. It'll all be over in a second. We can stand anything for a second.
No, no, Roy, I can't do it. I'm going to tell...
Listen, Monty. We tell the whole brigade will be wiped out. 3,000 men, and they all want to live, too. You wouldn't spoil our chances, would you?
Well, that's not my business. I didn't start this war. I didn't get them into this mess. Let them take care of themselves. They'll get wiped out sooner or later anyway. I want to live. Live. You won't tell what I'll tell.
Listen, Monty!
I'll tell.
Monty!
I'll listen. Let me out. I'll tell everything I know. The brigade is moving up. They're going to attack me. Roy!
Monty! Monty!
Don't cry, Roy. It was the only thing you could do. Brigade, Roy.
Yes, Monty.
They'll be all right now, won't they?
Yes.
Who's that?
It's the general.
You thought we'd tell, didn't you? Good old Roy. He won't tell, and I... forgotten it all. Oh, Roy, Roy.
Yes?
Where are you? Don't go away, Roy.
Come here, Monty. Can't you feel me holding you?
Hello, Carl. The gates. Cold up here in the night patrol. Awful up here in the dark. Oh, I'm afraid. Look out! Look out! We're falling! We're gonna crash! Do something, Roy! Wait! Wait! Wait!
All right, Monty. Monty! It's all right. Marty! Marty! Oh. Well? What my brother said.
Your brother?
I'll never tell you anything.
Die Disposition des Gefangenen, Exzellenz. Wird er erschossen?
Leider bleibt uns nichts anderes übrig.
Aber der Exzellenz.
Achtung! Nun, Exzellenz, haben wir Informationen?
Gar nichts.
Exzellenz, ich dachte, es sei alles abgemacht.
Ich dachte auch. Die Engländer sind eine tapfere Nation.
Zum Teufel mit den Engländern! Wir müssen Informationen herausbekommen.
Nun, halt!
Legs up. That's square up.
I'll be with you in just a minute, Monty.
It's your trust, fellow. Castle, gay lad. Legs up. Give fair. That's square river. Don't forward fast.
Nun, Exzellenz, diese Stellung hier.
Was ist der Angriff? Exzellenz, englische Truppen in großer Anzahl greifen an.
Hallo, Hauptquartier! 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 Raus, du Karo!